What's up, YouTube? It's your boy Views, bringing us a brand new video. And in this video, I'm going to be showing you guys how I get so many contact dunks and some slasher tips you might not know about, and also my player build, because that's probably one of the most asked questions on my channel. So yeah, starting off with how I get all these contact dunks you see in my videos, the two most important things you must have as a slasher are Hall of Fame posterizer and your contact dunks. So what I mean by this is, when you go to equip your dunk packages, you're not going to want to have the Zach LaVine or Vince Carter ones, none of those. Not even the one-handed rim grazers, because those are only going to make it harder for you to get contact animation. So what I do is only have your athletic flushes, which are the only exception, and any of the other standing dunks. But besides that, nothing else. And then, of course, all three contact packages. And some people don't use all three just because they want to get a certain animation. But if you're trying to get a posterizer every time you drive, you're going to want to put all three, because what this does is, no matter what angle you're coming from, there's going to be animation for it. So it's going to automatically do it. And of course, just because 2K nerfed the contact dunks this year, which kind of sucks because it's so easy to jump out of the animation and get blocked now, but you just got to get lucky. And that's another thing. When you see my videos, a lot of people ask how I don't get blocked, but I get blocked more than half the time. Trust me. Like, I'm pretty sure a lot of you get way more contact dunks than I do. But yeah, those are the two things every slasher should have. And moving on to a kind of debatable topic, it's your strength. And honestly, I can't answer that, and I don't even know if anyone can, because it'd be common sense for someone to get more dunks because of their strength, but it's 2K and you really can't tell. But for that reason, I put mine at halfway, and I can't say that it helped or not, but if you have the VC and extra upgrades, might as well upgrade all the way, why not? But so yeah, strength kind of matters. Another question I get asked a lot is what I use to dunk, and the answer is a stick, not square, because when you use a stick, you can choose what hand you want, and that's actually super helpful if you're playing smart and the opponent's on the right side of the rim, then you go for the left hand dunk so it doesn't block it. But honestly, I just hold it down all the time, because when you hold it down, it gives you the most flashy contact dunk, which is usually a windmill or just another nasty type of dunk. But yeah, I don't use square. I point the stick down. And when people ask why I chose to make my arm short, it's to have a little bit of a jump shot, because you don't want to just be limited to dunking, because if you can't shoot at all, then your opponent's going to realize that and most likely play back on you, which is super annoying. And if you don't know what I mean, this is what I'm talking about. And he's just going to wait for you in the paint, basically, and force you to drive. But if you can shoot and he leaves you open, then why not take the shot and have a chance of making it instead of just driving and risk getting blocked? But yeah, my dude has a 65 three-pointer, and with the boost, it's a 70. So more than half the time, if I'm open, it's going in. Now, when we're talking about badges for slashers, of course, you're going to have all the Hall of Fame ones. But the shooting ones are the ones that people sleep on the most. And the ones I'm talking about are these, because these just bring your game to a whole nother level. And when you're able to shoot a little bit and then bang on people and just dominate the paint, it's honestly so fun. And that's honestly one of the main reasons that I don't use my playmaker anymore. Now, moving on to my player build. If you guys have been with me since the beginning of 2K17, you guys should know by now with my build. But every time I stream, at least 20 people, I'm not lying, or even more. But a lot of you guys ask what's my build, and I just thought I'd show you guys again. But here it is. It's a 6'7 slasher point guard, max weight, shortest wingspan, and biggest shoulder width. And the shoulder width doesn't matter. That's just for looks, I'm pretty sure. But yeah, there it goes. And that's basically it for this video, guys. If y'all want to see my signature styles, I still haven't changed them from the last one I made, so that's why I haven't made a new one. But I'll link that in the description below for you guys that want to see them. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. And if you did, please drop a like. And if you're new, subscribe. And as always, thanks for watching.
If you haven't checked out, go to the Where you at? Come here, bitch, my confess. Oh my god. I just put up in the floor, right? Ooh. Put the next one to get ready. I fuck with you, dude. Green light. Where you at? Bang, bang. Let's fucking go, dude. 23. Holy fuck, 11 for 13, I'm too rough. Let's go! Holy fuck. Oh my god. No way, dude, that shit was already in. Ooh. Oh my god, dude, fucking rough. Holy fuck. All right, y'all. I'm getting off.